Welcome. Let's create a space where you can give yourself time and space to be by yourself or with somebody you want to share this practice with, where you won't be interrupted. Just carve out some time for yourself. Sit quietly, however feels good for you to sit today. And take a moment to really listen to your body, to this beautiful container that holds your spirit. It helps you interact with this beautiful planet we live on. Your gateway into a physical existence. Breathe into your body. Inhaling. Exhaling into this beautiful gateway. I'd like to share a story with you. From an experience I had working with sea turtles. In the dark of night, a faint glow emits from snow-white sand. Is it from a celestial or mundane source? It's really difficult to say. The dim luster allows me to see the expanding dark spot in the center of the sea turtle nest. Sea turtles arising from the depths of Mother Earth. Through a stethoscope, I hear cascading sand as it rushes to fill collapsing eggshells. Contractions of labor. Over the next 2 hours, one dark spot. A nose, perhaps breathing the first breath of unobstructed fresh air, becomes two, three, four, too many noses to count. In the very low light, I see darkness grow and expand past edges of the round nest chamber. I kneel to watch and hear tiny turtle bodies crawling over each other, preparing for their march to the sea. Another sound captures my attention. Faint chirps are exchanged as hatchlings communicate with each other. So sweet is their sound, so precious. Bioluminescence illuminates waves as they roll onto shore. Finally, the turtles erupt in a massive contraction and begin their crawl to the sea. Stars peek through clouds. A soft wind wraps around all human souls who witness the birth of 105 loggerhead souls into the sea. And I would like to ask you if there's a part of you that is wishing and wanting to be born, that is going through the contractions of labor. The Mother Earth is laboring and moving you out, helping you birth a new part of yourself. So I'd like to ask you to think about that as we practice together today. Think about holding that intention of allowing a part of you that wants so badly to crawl into that ocean of oneness with those beautiful stars lighting your way. To invite that part of you to be born. So move into child's pose. Spread your knees so that your heart can be cradled as your head touches, the forehead touches the earth, the mat, the floor. Bow in an invitation for this part of you to be birthed, to be born. Like little tiny, tiny nymphs, insect nymphs that float in the water and live in the water. And then at some point, that shell that they were breaks free and something completely and totally different emerges. So what wants to emerge today for you? How do you wish to transform into something maybe totally different, maybe a little different? And as an indication that you're willing to invite that part of you into this process, this life, I invite you to rise up on your knees and lift your arms up, lift your hands up. Take a nice deep breath in and then bring your hands to your heart. And exhaling, and then keep your fingers, your pinky and thumb and your wrist together, and then open your other fingers like a lotus mudra, a lotus blossom, inviting that beautiful part of you to be birthed into this place. And then come back into a squat. And if your back of your legs are not stretchy enough, you can put your fist under your heels. But try to put your heels down. Work on that, because as you squat, you're opening up your colon. What a great way to eliminate things we don't need. So I always include this stretch in my practice. And sometimes I'll do just this and sit and as a way to really open up that whole bottom chakra, that bottom energy center. Maybe put your hands up to your forehead, to your third eye, or use your knees to resist moving in and your elbows or out. Put them on the outside of your knees, your elbows. Building the strength of your legs and your ability to stretch out into this position. And then if you can, balance on your toes. Come up in that squat, but lift your heels and balance on your toes. And then drop back down. And then come into a forward fold, a standing forward fold or forward bend. Rise up halfway, flat back, and then drop back down into a forward fold. And then inhale and come up, raising your arms up over your head. And then exhaling your hands to your heart. Inviting in this part of you that wishes to be birthed. Inviting in the elements of earth and air and fire and water to help us in our rebirth. Igniting the passion budding breath of life, inviting flow and then containment so that we feel safe enough to do this. Because support and safety precedes movement. It doesn't mean we have to feel safe all the time, but to move forward, but it does help if we have a little bit of that container of earth. Let your hands relax down to your sides. Step back with your right foot a little bit and come up into Warrior One. Nice arch, a little bit of an arch to the back as you let your hands move a little bit behind you, and then step forward so that your feet are together. And with your hands still up, take your right hand and pull your left arm over. Take your right hand, hold the wrist of your left hand, and then pull the arm over into a nice side stretch. And come back to center. And left hand to right wrist, and stretch to the left. And then come up, arms down to your heart center, flowing down to your sides, and then inhale, step back left a little bit, come up into Warrior One on the left, a little bit of a back bend and arch. And then step forward with your left foot, grasp with your left hand, grasp your right wrist. Again, stretch to the left, and then come up and switch sides, right hand on left wrist, and stretch to the right. Come back to center, drop your hands to your heart, and once again, opening your hands, holding your pinky and your thumbs together and your wrist, and then opening your hands, your fingers, into like a lotus blossom. Blooming, becoming something more. And then once again, go back into Warrior One on the right. Right foot steps back a little bit. And then bring your hands to your heart again. And like those little insects that are so tiny and small, and then something cracks within their exoskeleton, and they become something completely and totally different, with wings instead of gills. So let your arms unfold, step back bigger into Warrior Two with your right foot, your toes facing or close to facing the long edge of your mat. What would it feel like to become something just totally new and different? Like, at one point you were swimming in the creek, and then all of a sudden you're flying over the creek. You shifted. You became something different. What would that feel like in your life to not just transform, but to transmute, completely change? And then pick up your heel on your back foot, your right foot, turns and face forward, hands forward, and then step together so that your feet step forward, so that your feet are together. Inhale, raise your arms overhead, forward fold, emptying, letting go of all that you used to be. Coming up halfway, looking at the horizon, at the possibilities of what you might become, what you might birth into, and then letting go again, forward fold, emptying that belly out, letting go. And then rising up, hands overhead, stepping back left a little bit into Warrior One. The potential of change is always within us. Sometimes it takes just recognition that we actually can change, we can actually do it. So bring your hands to your heart. Hold that seed of change in your heart space And then step back, quarter turn, step back left, quarter turn to the left into warrior two, opening up, becoming something different, moving from a smaller version of yourself to a much larger something else and a different expression of who you are. Different, evolving, changing, becoming. Feeling the contractions of the Earth Mother as she helps you birth into something new and different. Then lift your left heel, your back leg, back heel up. Twist and turn towards the front. Step together, bring your back foot to the front. Raise your arms up overhead. And then swan dive gracefully, beautifully down, forward folding, exhaling, letting go. Letting go of expectations. Letting go of everything that you no longer need in your life. And that most assuredly is generally our own opinions about who we are. Come up halfway, flat back. And empty out more of those judgments you might have, letting go of what you believe to be wrong with yourself, and then rising up into a really cool expression of this beautiful who you really are, not that negative stuff you were taught, that society taught you or that people taught you growing up, letting go of the opinions you formed about yourself. And dropping your hands to your side, standing in mountain pose, feeling the earth, the strength of the earth, the strength of your own being. And then coming into powerful pose where we drop our seat back, engaging our thighs and our legs, and then raising our arms up like at a 45 degree angle. And think of this, think of you being in that place of transformation where you're just breaking free of that shell, and let your hands be like the wings coming out of that shell, and then gradually stand up slowly and bring your arms to your sides, but opening them up like wings of a newborn creature. And then drop back into powerful pose, arms back up, feeling the strength of your legs, feeling the strength of your new wings as they start to come out of that shell, and then slowly stand up, moving your wings. And then once more, powerful pose. This time your hands stay at your heart, your legs strong and bent, your seat back. And this time with powerful pose, as your hands are at your heart, think of your heart opening like that. Like your heart being the center of something new being born within you. And breathe into that space, opening your hands to the sides, standing up strong, letting your hands float gently and slowly back into mountain pose. Breathing in mountain pose. Raise your hands and inhale as you do so. Raise your hands overhead and then exhale, forward fold. Come up for space, inhaling halfway, exhaling into plank. Take a moment or two or three in plank to feel your strength. And then push back into down dog. Stretching out, walking your dog, stretching the backs of your legs, alternating. Resting in down dog. And then coming back into plank. And then allowing yourself to lower gently to the floor, keeping your elbows close to your sides. Come down into cobra. And then push back into down dog. Walk or hop forward into a forward fold. Inhale and rise up. Feeling those new wings as they stretch and move in your body. Lowering your hands to your sides. Shifting your weight to your right foot. Bringing your left knee up. Flexing your foot into a balanced pose. Strong arms and hands. Relaxed but strong. To add support to this balance. And then lower your foot, your left foot, stand in your left foot, now transferring the weight to the left. Raise your right knee up, flex your foot. Feel that balance. And then lower your right foot, stand in mountain pose. Feet are hip width distance apart. And then transfer once again your weight to your right foot. And we're going to do eagle on the right side. Bringing your left leg around your right, and you can have a toe on the floor on the other side of your right foot, the outside edge of your right foot, or you can bring it on around, wrap it around the knee, and then the left arm goes under, the right arm goes under the left elbow. Feeling that balance of eagle as it's ready to take flight. And then ever so gently, unfold and allow yourself to come into warrior three, but a flying warrior, where you're bending forward, strong leg, arms out to the side, you're soaring, feeling the strength of your arms, and then come back into standing position, feet side by side, arms at your side, and then transfer your weight into your left foot. And bring your right knee up and wrap it around the left, the outside edge of the left leg. Touch using the toes for balance or wrapping further, whatever works for you. Then coming under the right arm with the left arm. And feeling that eagle poised to fly, ready. And then allowing that eagle to gently unfold. Balancing in warrior three with your arms spread wide like an eagle in flight. And allow yourself that flight. Feel the flight of something new within you being born. And then step your feet together and stand in mountain pose. I think balance is so important physically and emotionally and spiritually and mentally. I think that's one of the things that we work on a lot when we're practicing yoga. And of course, the physical balance influences all of the other too. So let's do one more balance pose, please. Tree pose, standing with your weight in your right foot. Your left foot can stay at the ankle, or it can come up to the calf or the inside of the thigh, but not pressing against the knee. We want to stay clear of that area. And then bring your arms, your hands to your heart, and open up that tree. As your foot is rooted and growing roots deep into the earth, open the branches up of your arms and feel the movement of that tree as it flexes and bends with what life brings. And then gently bring your branches, your arms down to your side, lower your foot gently. Stand in mountain pose, take a deep breath. Then take another deep breath. Then stand in your left foot, tree pose on the left side. Foot, the right foot is at the ankle, the calf, or the inner thigh, while your hands are at your heart center, blooming, blossoming, raising up into the sky as your branches move out and moving. Trees always move, even huge trees move and sway. So feel what that feels like to allow your branches, your arms to sway and move. And then gently and slowly lower your foot to the floor so that both feet are on the floor. Your hands are at your sides once again in mountain pose. And as you stand in mountain pose, think of that first intention we started with, of inviting something within us to be born that really is ready, that's waiting at the top of our being, just poised to come out of that shell of the old, to transform, to transmute into something new. So think about that. Invite that in. And transfer your weight into your right foot and come down into warrior three of your choice. With your hands in the front, to the side, one hand forward, one hand back. Just feel, play with that balance of the strength of becoming more than maybe what you even thought you could be. Challenging yourself with a pose that sometimes is challenging for even people that have done yoga for many years, but allowing yourself to be challenged, it's okay. So also okay to lose your balance and fall, as long as you don't hurt yourself, of course, we don't want that. But you know, allow yourself the levity of spirit to laugh when you fall or stumble or whatever. And then come back into standing position, mountain pose. And while we're still with our weight in our right foot or leg, we're going to do another pose where we lean forward to half moon with our right hand touching the floor. Our left arm up, our left leg behind us. Expanding, becoming more. Bigger, balanced, beautiful. And then come back into standing mountain pose. Transfer your weight to your left leg and then come into warrior three, the arms of your choice. Reaching forward, feeling yourself bring the space for this new part of yourself being born. Or one hand reaching forward, another hand reaching back, holding that balance for other people as well. Or flying into this new place within yourself and the world. And then allowing yourself to come up into standing, and then going right down into half moon on the left fingers touching the floor or reaching towards the floor, right leg back. Flexing the foot can help with balance. And then right arm up, feeling that beautiful stretch, that stretching balance pose. And then coming back into standing, mountain pose, feeling the earth, the container of the earth holding each of us in our life. And the container of our body, this beautiful, beautiful gateway of our body that holds our spirit, that allows us to exist in this place, in this beautiful place. So find your way to a seated position now. Your legs stretched out in front of you, and raise your arms up to the sky, stretching out, allowing that old crackled shell to break free as you stretch forward and reach for your toes. Allowing the wings to move, your spiritual wings or the energetic wings, however you want to look at it. Think about it. Beautiful stretching, opening, and coming back up into seated position. Come into a wide straddle with your legs open. And then reach with your left hand towards your left toes, and then twist to the right. Raise your right arm up, and then allow your right side to bend over towards the left arm, the left leg, and touch, opening that whole right side body, feeling that expansion that happens as you take the risk to open up. Come back up and bring your right foot towards your left thigh or towards your left calf. With your knees still on the floor, turn a little bit so that you're moving into a stretch over that left leg, and then stretch out, reaching for your toes. Come back up, open the leg out again, and then reach for your right toes with your right arm, your right hand. Open, twist to the left, bringing that left arm up, and then over your head, reaching for the right arm, reaching, opening, stretching, coming back up. Left foot comes to the right leg, a position that it works for you, and then turn a little bit so that you're over that right leg, and then reach towards your toes, stretching for your right toes, your right foot, opening. And then slowly come up, feet back out in front of you, toes pointing towards the ceiling, and then stretch over them again, forward fold on the floor. And then come back up gently. And this time, I'm gonna ask you to lay down so that your back is on the floor, and bring your knees into your chest and hug them for all of the hard work that you've done in your lifetime, all of the ways that you have worked so hard to open up and to change and to transform and to transmute. Giving yourself a big hug for all of your hard work. And then dropping your knees over to the right, your head looks left, your arms are in a T. Breathing like this for just a bit. Feeling the twist, the open and the beautiful opening. Bring your knees up and just drop them to the left while you look with your head to the right. arms still in that T. Unwinding, twisting, opening. And then bring your knees back up and hug them into your chest. And then allow yourself to go into happy baby, where you reach between your bent legs towards your feet. Hold the outside edges of your feet and just play like a baby would play. How it feels to allow yourself movement and joy at just opening and being present. And then come back to center. Stretch out. Feet to the corners of the mat, hands towards your sides. Or you could put a hand on your belly and your heart. Or you could lay on your side. Just find a comfortable place to be for a bit. What is it that you're wanting to birth in your life? Not something you're doing. Something that has to do with your being. What is it that you're becoming? What is it that is being birthed? What threshold of transmutation and change are you on? And just allow yourself to be there. To be in it. Supported by Earth. Feeling the earth supporting your body. Feeling the air support you as you breathe in. Feeling the fire of your spirit right there with you, supporting you. And the flow of water in your body as your blood moves through your body. As the moisture in your mouth moves as you swallow. Completely and totally supported by the elements, of which you are part. What is it that is transmuting today for you? In a moment, I'm going to ask you to slowly sit up, but before you do that, I want you to find a place in your body where you can hold and breathe into and affirm that you are holding a space for transformation, transmutation. You're holding a space to become something completely and totally new and different and wonderful within you, being birthed. Breathe into that place. When you're ready, roll to one side and then slowly sit up. in hero's pose or easy pose, however you want to sit, as we come together for this final part of our time together today. I'd like to invite you to open your hands up on your knees or at your heart, or hold them in your lap to receive. May we know, and recognize the support that we have in our lives as we walk through changes, as we fly into new versions of who we are. May we know without a doubt that support is always available. And part of our responsibility is to seek out support when we need it. Through friendships, through classes, through reading, sometimes therapy, through spiritual practice and meditation, music. May we know how to support ourselves and know that we can absolutely support ourselves. And so may it be for you, and so may it be for me, and so may it be for all of us. Thank you, my friends.